Are you ready to be here? Let's welcome the president of the Ultimate Fighting Championships back to Toronto, ladies and gentlemen. What's up, guys? How are you? Thanks for coming out today. I appreciate it very much. You know how I feel about Canada, man. This is the mecca of mixed martial arts, and we're working hard to try to get up here, put on a live event in your hometown, finally. So how's this thing going to work? How are we going to ask questions? You guys going to pass a mic around, or is there a mic? How's this going to work? The mics are in the back. What's that? Jeff? All right, we got standing mics and we got people walking around. Who wants to ask a question? No? They don't?
No, this is all I want to ask. No, Fader.
Fader! We'll see what happens. You know, obviously, I know everybody wants to see that fight, and everybody knows that I like putting out the best fights. My job is to put out fights that people want to see. So I know people want to see that fight, so...
Buy that contract!
I've been working on it for a very long time. It takes two people to make a deal, you know what I mean?
Oh, shit.
I'm willing, I'm ready.
Standing here to your right?
Yeah, Cordova forgot his passport and can't get out of the country now. Yeah. He's gonna stay here another night. Big guy.
Dino Musasi. You expect to see him in the UFC?
Yeah, I like Musasi too. Yeah, I'm interested in Musasi. And, you know, again, when these guys' contracts are up, I'm in the bidding. I'm interested, and I'd love to see him in the UFC. Any of the guys who would consider, you know, possibly the best in the world, I want to get him here fighting.
Over here.
He just asked me if we can expect to see John Jones versus Anderson Silva anytime in the future. John Jones has been a buzz for the last couple of days.
Yeah!
And, you know, he's young. This kid's like 22 years old. He's so young. I want to take it. You know, I want to give him three good fights. Grant Farrow was a big test. He obviously passed the flying colors. I want to give him some other fights like that over the next year, next three fights. And then I say, you know, next year, after his next three fights, we start getting him Rashad, Rampage, Lyoto Machida, and Shogun, whoever the champion is, and maybe he gets a title fight next year. Okay? Where's the other mic?
Back here, over here, Dave.
Okay. Tom, there you go. What's up, man?
Jake Shields' contract is up now, soon. Are you guys negotiating with him, or?
No, we're not negotiating, but you know what they're doing to him in the Bush League. They're putting him in against a 185-pounder when he's the champion because they're trying to get him beat because he's on the last fight of his contract. So we'll see what happens with Jake. You know, I'm interested in him. He's a good kid, and, you know, obviously a good fighter, so yes.
Can we get our picture taken with you after?
Absolutely. I'll stay here all day and take a picture with everybody.
Yeah! Yeah, we gotta go get
out. I know you're a fan,
but... I know. Thank you. Getting high is definitely more important, trust me.
Dude, I'm putting down my first
lot
today.
That's cool. You got a lot. Enough money for weed, eh? Like, I live in Toronto, I don't roll around that much money.
Yeah, he's asking me about fighter salaries and how much some of these guys make, some of the younger fighters. First of all, you know, some of the guys, when you talk about guys that make 5 and 5, they're guys who get into the UFC, you know, and they usually have 3, 5, 7, 8, 5, 7, 10, whatever the numbers are. The reality is, some of these guys have been around for a long time. I'll give you a better example. John Jones, a guy like John Jones, probably for that fight the other day, he probably made $40,000. Now he's a guy whose contract is coming up. He'll get into bigger money, and if this guy ends up becoming, you know, one of the top contenders or champion, he makes a lot of money. And we probably have 12 to 15 guys that make millions of dollars. This sport is only 9 years old. You know what I mean? It's been 9 years. The fact that from where we came from to now, these guys are making millions of dollars. Some of the guys are making hundreds of thousands of dollars. and some of the lower level guys make anywhere from $50,000, $60,000, $100,000 a year. You know, pretty good place to be in 9 years.
I think it's great. I agree with you 100%. And I'm just asking the question, right?
Yeah, no. Dude, you guys can ask me any question you want to. You don't scare me. Ask me whatever you want. Thank you.
Dan, how long before this becomes an Olympic sport?
You know what? People ask me that all the time. I think it should be an Olympic sport. Judo's an Olympic sport, wrestling's an Olympic sport, taekwondo, boxing. This is just all of it rolled into one. I hope I'm alive to see it. You know, I think it's eventually going to happen someday. But that's not my job. I'm not fighting that fight, man. I got enough problems. I got to get Ontario and stuff like that. I'm worried about the Olympics. That somebody else is going to have to do that one. But I hope I'm alive to see it. It should happen. What's that?
What's the
UFC for women. Oh, I'm sorry. Wait. She just asked, when's UFC for women going to happen? All right.
Yes.
Let me explain this. Now,
Cyborg!
If you guys remember when women's boxing exploded, there were a couple of girls out there that were really good and other girls that were not. Okay? Now, my position on women, the female fighting in the UFC is, a couple of years ago our heavyweight division was really thin, and it's just starting to get really stacked and good now. The women's division just isn't that big enough right now, you know? And I saw a fight one time up in Northern California, and I know this is going to sound sexist, and, you know, I'll be apologizing tomorrow to everybody again, but this is the truth. True story to how I feel about it. I saw a fight up in Northern California, okay? And there was this girl who fought like Randy Couture and looked just like Randy Couture, okay? And she fought this really pretty girl that looked like she'd taken 3 Taibo classes. And it was one of the worst things I've ever watched. And I wasn't a big fan. But there are some female fighters out there that are really talented.